then you say, Miss Burgoyne, as she quite often does, which is obnoxious in itself, has a strong belief that her client is innocent. I have no strong belief that my client has innocence. I have no belief whatsoever, and I form no beliefs whatsoever, and it would be highly improper for an attorney to do so. So to be so accused was extremely obnoxious, frankly. But I think that a totally subjective belief, and that made it worse, because now you're telling me you know what's in my mind, but you have no way of knowing what's in my mind. A subjective belief isn't one of the factors listed in the courtroom, and I told you it's not subjective. And then you say, well, it's your opinion, Mrs. Burgoyne. How do you know what my...
So, I think there is some factual support for what the court said now. In terms of the phrasing about totally subjective, probably shouldn't have said totally, but I was trying to make the point that as the court analyzed the bond decision, the attorneys, whether the opinions or the beliefs, are just not one of the factors the court has to evaluate. I think at this point I can be fair to Mr. Burns, and I will certainly do that. But this motion today is a reminder to me that I probably need to step back a bit and be a little more guarded. From this point, I'll certainly probably do.